For years, we've been told crash diets don't work and that depriving your body in the short term will eventually lead to long-term weight gain. But Dr. Michael Mosley is turning everything we know about dieting on its head, first with the 5-2 and now with the fast 800. And Dr. Mosley is with us on the couch. It's nice to see you again.
Lovely to see you again.
All right, so tell us what we have got wrong about dieting.
Sure, the idea was, you know, you need to lose weight slowly and steadily, and that's been the sort of mantra for many years. But actually what the scientists have been telling me for some time now is that you can be better off doing rapid weight loss diet, and that is 800 calories a day. And there have been two really big studies in the UK which demonstrated where they took groups of people, more than 300 people, and randomly allocated them to either rapid weight loss or slow and steady. And it was those that did the rapid weight loss who lost the most weight, 10 kilos, sustained for nearly 2 years, whereas the other lot, they didn't lose much weight and they put it on again. So it turns what you believe on its head. There's another big study out of Oxford which says that, and there is an even bigger study coming out of Australia which will also say that. So
scientifically, it has been proven.
Oh, undoubtedly. I mean, you have to eat properly because...
So no cabbage soup diets?
Well, the problem with some of the diets which were done in the past is they were kind of crazy. But what you need to do is have a balanced diet. There must be enough nutrients, there must be enough protein in particular, because if you don't get enough protein, then what happens is your body will start to kind of suck the protein out of your muscle.
And you'll... With your fast 800, you talk about inflammation. Now, inflammation in the next few years is going to be a very, very important area. Explain.
Absolutely. So inflammation basically is your body's response. It normally happens, you cut yourself, you get an inflammatory response. But if it goes on and becomes chronic, then you have problems. If it goes on in the brain, for example, it's now seen as a leading cause of depression and anxiety. Mm-hmm. It is obviously one of the leading causes of breast cancer, type 2 diabetes. And just having too much fat, particularly around the gut, the fat actually produces inflammatory factors which spread throughout your body. So simply losing some weight will reduce inflammation. I'm actually talking at a big international conference on inflammation here in September in Sydney. And Sydney's kind of bringing together all the great experts. Mm-hmm. And then I'm going to be doing a talking tour. Talking about the wonders of human body after that. So I love Australia. I'm back here regularly.
What's the difference? Because you are very big on fasting. What's the difference between fasting and starving yourself?
Sure. So fasting doesn't mean completely abstaining from food. I recommend 800 calories a day on your fasting days.
And this is an example of what 800 calories looks like, according to your cookbook. Yeah,
slightly under, actually, that one. So what you've got is some yogurt and some berries. Yogurt's full-fat yogurt. It's Greek yogurt, it's got lots of protein, and it's very tasty. Berries are a low source of sugar, and that's probably less than 200 calories.
Because you also say there's certain fruits that you shouldn't have. These berries are good. What shouldn't you have in terms of fruit?
Sadly, the really sweet ones. So it's the things like the melons and the grapes. They tend to shove your blood sugars up.
Okay.
You're much better off with apples and pears and things like that, and keep
and
the skin
berries.
On. And berries as well. Berries are really cunning because they taste sweet, but actually things like strawberries have very low sugar in them.
Mm-hmm. Who knew? And then the Mediterranean salad.
Absolutely, Mediterranean salad. I love Mediterranean salad. A Mediterranean diet is the healthiest diet on the planet. You splash on the olive oil, you've got plenty of olives there and tomatoes and cucumber. And, of course, you've got feta cheese. So that's going to be good for you. And that thing comes, again, at around 250 calories. And you might have that for lunch, or this is a kind of soup you could have instead for lunch, and that's, again, about 200 calories. Tomato. And on your non-fasting days, when you're kind of eating more calories, you can enhance these. In the book, basically, we show how you can, for example, with that, you'd add a little bit of bacon or chorizo or whatever, or a bit of cheese, a bit of pita bread.
But your book is full of these type of recipes.
Oh, absolutely.
That's the thing you find, what am I going to eat? And it's too confusing. So if you've got the recipe there, It's easier.
Absolutely. And the thing that people tell me, because we've been running we have an online course to support people as well, and we've been tracking them to find out how they're doing, and on they're averaging about 1 to 2 kilos a week. Mm-hmm. So in the first 8 weeks, they lose an average of 10 kilos.
Now, Dr. Mosley, intermittent fasting is all the rage. Why does this work?
The reason is because you're giving your body a rest from food, and it turns out that is a good idea. So in the original 5-2 diet, what I suggested is you cut calories down to about 600, and now say 800, because 800 works better. And then there is another form of intermittent fasting called time-restricted eating, where you stop eating at 8 o'clock at night and then you don't start again until, say, 12 o'clock the next day.
We have so many more questions for you. In fact, we put out a call on our Facebook page, and here are some of the questions that people would like to ask you. The first one is from Jenny. She says she has an early dinner around 7 o'clock, but about 2 hours later, she's hungry again. What should she do?
I think she should look at what she's eating at 7 o'clock, and if she tries some of the recipes, she may find that they keep her fuller for longer. And the other thing, perhaps, is to extend her fast at the other end of the day, so have her breakfast much later.
Constance asks, what are the best foods to eat to lose weight if you're a vegan?
OK, vegan's obviously tricky, but what you need to do is, you know, nuts are fabulous. Oil, olive oil, things like that. There are lots of meat substitutes out there now. And you must make sure... You probably need to be taking a vitamin supplement because the biggest issue, if you're on a vegan diet, is making sure you're getting all the vitamins and minerals you need.
All right, what about this one? This is from Melissa. She says, when I fast, I get really emotional and I snap at people really easily. I also get quite bad nausea. Any tips on how to prevent this?
Sure, I mean, one of the things that happened was in the original 5-2, I suggested women eat 500 calories a day. And that was based on the studies done then, particularly they were animal studies. I now say 800 calories. And most people find 800 calories is a lot more tolerable. I mean, if you had a go at this sort of thing?
I tried the six. I'm underweight.
Is that working better for you?
Much better.
Yeah.
It's doable for me.
Absolutely, and that's what we found, is that basically people reported it being much more doable. They got less grumpy, and it seemed to be low enough to trigger the desirable metabolic changes, like burning the fat, but high enough to stop getting grumpy.
Kim has asked, you're a self-confessed chocoholic. How do you resist it, or don't you?
By keeping it out of the house. So my wife has no sweet tooth. She kind of writes all the recipes here. And so I know occasionally it's there, so I go sneaking around looking for it, but I never find it.
Is dark chocolate a better substitute?
I've tried all sorts of substitutes. I've tried dark, really dark chocolate. And the great thing about dark chocolate, I don't really like
it's terrible.
Yes, I know.
It's so bitter.
And all carob.
And it just...
But, you know, sometimes just smelling some vanilla essence is enough to
Give that one a go. I haven't found anything yet that takes my chocolate.
Sam has this question. Doesn't crash dieting slow down your metabolism? Yeah. I crash dieted in my teens, and when I stopped, I got fatter than before I started.
Sure. I mean, the old diets, as I said, were very poor. They were in low in protein. If you do something like a juicing diet where you're not getting enough protein, then you're going to lose your muscle, your metabolic rate will slow down. But if you do a proper, controlled 800-calorie diet, the sort I'm describing, then that does not happen. As I said, they have now done this in many, many hundreds of people.
Connie here asks, out of the fast 800, 5-2 or 16-8 diets, these numbers anyway. Which is the best option for 65-plus age group who find it almost impossible to shift kilos? And as we know, as you age, it is more difficult.
Absolutely. So my approach is actually to combine all of those things. Mm. So what I suggest is a sort of three-tiered approach. Mm. You start, if it's suitable for you, doing the rapid weight loss for a couple of weeks, which will kick things off, and it's hugely motivating. Then you can switch to the sort of 5-2 approach where you're just eating 800 calories a couple of days a week, and the other 5 days a week you're eating healthily. And while you're doing that, I recommend doing this thing called time-restricted eating, where you cut your... You basically extend the overnight fast.
So what happens when you do not put food in your stomach for 12 hours or 14 hours or 16 hours?
Sure.
What happens?
What happens is we are rather like a hybrid car. We're designed to run on two fuels, on sugar and on fat. And only when your sugar supply starts to go down do you switch into fat burning. And that takes about 10 hours without food. And what also happens, and then it exponentially takes off. So the idea that, you know, you have to eat all the time and keep your blood sugars up, that's terrible, terrible advice.
So you only start burning the fat after 10 hours?
Yes, unless you're exercising vigorously. Because that is kind of how nature designed us, if you like. You run on this fast accessible fuel, which is the sugar in your blood, and it's also stored as a thing called glycogen. And it's really only when that goes down that you go into the major fat burning. So most of us have enough fat to keep us going until next Christmas, frankly.
Oh, yeah. I'd say Christmas 2025.
I've got to ask, though, because for years we've been told that as soon as you get up, you have to have a really good breakfast. Yeah. You need to break the fast to get your metabolism going, and especially working early hours.
Yes. It's a myth. I'm afraid it's another great myth.
So you're saying that we shouldn't eat straight away?
If you love eating breakfast, the advice is very strongly do not eat within the first hour of waking. There's a guy called Sachin Panda who's a professor of chronobiology. He basically looked at the impact of your body clock and things like that. And he's kind of the person who helped create time-restricted eating, also known as 16-8. That's very popular with young people now, where you extend your fast, you skip breakfast, you eat later.
Now, so you only eat during that eight-hour window?
Window, exactly, say from 12 till 8 in the evening.
12?
Or I think it's
does coffee count? With
if
milk?
If it's black, without milk. Well, yeah, it's fine.
Actually, but I've done that for that, not the 16, but for the last 4 days, I've done the 10-hour fast.
That's very manageable, isn't it?
No, sorry, 14-10.
Wow.
And that
and
is manageable.
And I haven't been hungry.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, that was weird for me, because I'll eat anything.
So there was a big study which came out in the British Medical Journal recently in which they looked at all the studies and they said, actually, if you make people who don't like eating breakfast eat breakfast, they put on weight.
Wow.
So, again, they said that it's not a great strategy.
You are changing the way we eat, Dr. Mosley. The Fast 800 recipe book accompanies Michael Mosley's hugely successful Fast 800, and it is out now. Dr. Michael Mosley, always a pleasure when we have you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good luck with all.
I'm working on it.